السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد، سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Brothers and sisters, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept this beautiful month of Ramadan from all of us. May He raise us amongst the righteous on the day of Qiyamah. May He keep us amongst the righteous in this world as well, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill our lives with mercy and rahmah in this very beautiful month of Ramadan, on the day when, subhanallah, we will all be looking for the mercy, and may Allah grant us His shade and mercy in the day of Qiyamah as well, brothers and sisters. So alhamdulillah, today being our 17th day, where we are sharing reflections and counsels of the pious, and we have been going through different words of inspiration, which can truly be a means of changing our hearts and coming towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala soften our hearts and bring it closer towards Him. Because brothers and sisters, the ultimate goal for any believing man and woman is to truly find the closeness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is something that they should strive for, and this should be the main purpose of the life of every single believing man and woman, is to truly find that closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to find that closeness. So again, inshallah, from the beginning till the end of Ramadan, the counsels that I have been sharing with you, I want to make it consistent in a way that every counsel will have three subparts to it. And so that inshallah, not only one counsel, but multiple things we can take back, but of course, sum it together as one counsel together. So we continue towards today's counsel and advice. Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, who was a great scholar of his time, I had mentioned previously about him as well. Ibn Hajar, the word Ibn Hajar, the word Hajar in Arabic refers to stone or rock. And Ibn in Arabic refers to the sun, but it's also referred to as kunya, meaning relationship that is built. So for example, Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu is known as Abu or Hirra or Huraira, which means the father of the cat, which doesn't really make him the father of the cat, but shows that relationship or the connection or love or the care that he had for that. So when we talk about Ibn Hajar, it is actually a metaphoric term or a simile or analogy given to a person with extreme capacity of knowledge or memorization. So as they say in English, written in stone, like if you wrote something in stone, like you're not going to forget it, written in stone. So Ibn Hajar, rahimahullah ta'ala anhu, was a famous scholar for his memory. He is also a person who wrote one of the most detailed and most in-depth commentary of Sahih al-Bukhari, the authentic book of hadith, which has 9,000 few ahadith. He wrote a 25-volume detailed summary of it. Ibn Hajar mentions in his kitab, and he says, I just gave you the basic foundation to know who this person is, where are we getting our sources from, and where are we getting our advice from. So it's important to know, because we need to know the basis of who is giving us this advice in order to really comprehend over this. So a man with such caliber, Ibn Hajar mentions, and he writes, and he says, the happiest of the people are those with three traits in them. Meaning he's talking about the physical, traits that people have. So he says the happiest of the people are those with three traits or three characteristics. The first thing Ibn Hajar mentions is a person who is the happiest in this world is a person who has a sincere heart. A person who has a sincere heart. May Allah make us from amongst those. May Allah keep us happy in this world. May Allah keep us amongst those who will be happy on the day of Qiyamah as well, brothers and sisters. May He take away our gham and our worries and our difficulties in this world. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take away the gham and the difficulties of the day of Qiyamah as well. So Ibn Hajar mentions the happiest of the people are those with three traits. A person who has a sincere heart. And what does it mean to have a sincere heart and attachment to happiness? Because a person who has a sincere heart will never wait for the praise of others, right? a person will not wait for the appreciation of others, but they would know that they have done it only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I remember reading a story of one of these pious aslaf and predecessors of our. His name was Sheikh Yusuf Al-Kahandalwi. Sheikh Yusuf Al-Kahandalwi was one of the greatest scholars in Hind, who wrote a commentary on the life of Sahaba. The most beautiful commentary on the life of Sahaba is written by Sheikh Yusuf Rahimahullah ta'ala anhu in three volumes in Arabic, known as Hayatul Sahaba. So it says that one day he was giving some talk to the people who were sitting in his presence, and he gave this talk. And it was, Allah had bestowed him with eloquence, with beauty of speech. People would sit for hours and listen to him and they won't get bored. And subhanAllah, he gave this speech and he spoke to people. When the talk finished, one person, a villager, a dihati, a baddu, a Bedouin, a villager came and he sat in front of Sheikh Yusuf rahmatullah alayhi when the talk had finished. And he says, I traveled from so far away and I have come just to listen to your talk. And now I've heard that you have stopped your talk, meaning it's done. Like, this is the sincerity of the of those of our pious scholars. So with that same josh, that's a jazba or that strength and power and emotions and feeling, he gave that same speech again to that one man. So the students of his were like, Sheikh, like, we understand speaking in front of people in such a beautiful manner. There was only one person sitting now and you gave that speech just like you gave before. So Sheikh Rahimahullah ta'ala anhu said something so beautiful. He said in Urdu, I'll translate that in Urdu. I'll say in Urdu and translate that in English as well. He says, "Pehle bhi ek ke liye kahi, abhi bhi ek ke liye kahi." He says, in the beginning, the first time I said, I also said for one. And now I also said for one. Meaning, either it was for my own nafs to listen to it, and only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So sincere heart. A person who will have a sincere heart will be the happiest in this person in this world. Meaning a person would never wait for anyone to say, oh, you have done something good, because you know that your ajr is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So sincerity of heart is number one step towards true happiness. Because if people will look for the pleasure of people, we may never find that, brothers and sisters. We may never be able to. And that true happiness could never be there. So sincere heart is number one. Number two, patient body. Allahu Akbar. A body that is able to bear with patience on trials and difficulties that come to them. Meaning a body or a person who doesn't begin to complain with small difficulties that come to them. That's why Rasulullah ﷺ very often would ask dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah grant me a tongue that is busy and engaged in your remembrance. O Allah, grant me a heart that is humble and is always in your consciousness and your fear. And O Allah, grant me a body that is able to bear patience and difficulties upon trials that may come towards it. Of course, brothers and sisters, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to never put us in a trial and difficulty. May Allah never put us in a situation that we have to go through difficulty and bear with patience. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give us enough strength, because this world is a means of tests and trials. Allah mentions himself subhanahu wa ta'ala, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةِ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ أَمَلًا, that we created death and life as a test. This life is a test to see which one of you will do the best of actions. So Ibn Hajar mentions the first portion of a happiest person is a sincere heart. The second step towards that is a body that is patient, a person who's able to bear the difficulties. They're enjoying the moment and then and difficulty comes towards them, but subhanAllah, they're still patient with the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning they never come to a point that they begin to complain to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah has given them that patient body who is able to go through thick and thin in different situations of their life. And then Ibn Hajar mentions, and the third aspect and the final aspect of the happiest people are those who have the contentment of what they possess. Meaning the contentment, they are satisfied with the possessions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them. Meaning if you have people with these three characteristics, you will find them to be the happiest of the people. Number one, a person who is sincere in their heart. Meaning their heart is so sincere that it's not for anyone except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will always find them happy, those who are sincere for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, those who have patient body, meaning those who are able to go through situations knowing with sabr and patience, right? And that's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned to one of the sahabi, and he said that innama sabru in the sadmatil ula, that true patience is at the time of difficulty, meaning you are afflicted with situation, and then you have trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a body that is patient, that will allow a person to truly be happy and content in their life. And last but not least, the third portion which defines the true happiness of a person, Ibn Hajar mentions, is a person who has contentment, who person is radi and happy and satisfied in their possession. Meaning whatever Allah has given them subhanahu wa ta'ala, be it their homes and be it their lives and be it their wealth, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given and granted that person is always contentful. They have always shukr on their tongue. Meaning you never hear any complaint for that person. And brothers and sisters, this is what we get from the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yes, we do ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for certain situations to become better in our lives. We do go through situations in time where we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to, you know, better our halat and our conditions, but we never complain to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, that's the essence of iman. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had one of the most difficult days of his life, and I'll finish with this, was the day of Uhud. On the day of Uhud, it happened in the third year of the migration of the Prophet ﷺ in Medina. The day was so tough for the Prophet ﷺ that the Prophet ﷺ broke two of his molars. The armor that he was wearing went inside his cheek. The Prophet ﷺ's face became full of blood. The Prophet ﷺ was thrown inside a ditch. The Nabi of Allah ﷺ became unconscious. The Nabi of Allah ﷺ lost 70 of his Sahaba. His own beloved uncle was cut into pieces while his liver was taken out and was bitten by the enemies. Meaning it was the most difficult physical day of the life of the Prophet ﷺ. And then at this moment, he was asked, Aisha radiallahu anha asked, O Prophet ﷺ, was there a day more difficult than this day in your life? And the Nabi of Allah ﷺ said, yes, it was the day of Ta'if, when the people stoned me for miles. Meaning this was physically and emotionally the most difficult day was Ta'if. Emotionally, the physical day was Uhud, emotion. But with that 3 to 6 miles of continuous stoning, what was the word of Rasulullah ﷺ when he looked towards the heaven? He says, innama ashku du'fa quwwati wa qillata hilati. O Allah, the shikayat and the complaint that I have is not with you, but with the lack of my efforts, that I was not able to get this message to these people. Meaning even in this condition, he taught us that my Allah knows me better than I know myself. Contentment, contentment, contentment. And never complain, brothers and sisters. And of course, we can always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to better our conditions. And we should always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to better our ahwal and better our conditions, but never be able to complain, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts us in a situation that He knows that we can bear. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. He will never put us in a situation that we as insan cannot bear. So let's go back to what I began with, and inshallah we'll wrap this up. Ibn Hajar mentions and he says that the happiest of the people are those with a sincere heart. May Allah give us sincerity of our heart. May Allah give us the ability to always have every amal and every deed and every action of our lives only and solely for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's number one. Number two thing he mentioned is a person who has a patient body, a body that is able to go through situations and times and things that happen to them as halat and conditions, because this world is full of trials and tests. So if Allah gives that person a patient body. And number three, and contentment with what he or she possesses. Whatever you have in your life, Allah gives you sakoon and itminan in that. Meaning that person is not always hoping and wishing for more and more, but they are content and satisfied. And if Allah gives them more, this is the karam of Allah. This is the blessing of Allah. And we always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to always shower His mercy upon us. Always, always give us more blessings and more rahmah and more mercy. But indeed, for whatever we have currently in our lives, we should truly and truly be contentful and have the sukoon and shukr in our lives. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to truly make us from amongst those who have sincerity in their hearts. May Allah give us those bodies and lives that are able to be content and satisfied with the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the aspect of shukr and gratitude and thankfulness and contentment in our lives. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our fasting, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our qiyam, our siyam. Brothers and sisters, a quick reminder, inshallah, that every Sunday we also have the drive-through donation in Islamic Center of Long Island from 3 p.m. to 5 p.m. for many of us who are planning to give our Zakatul Fitr. Suggested price, inshallah, is $10. Then if Allah has blessed you more, the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam recommended the amount of dates, the amount of raisins, which is 3.75 pounds, which comes to be about $40 for the raisins and $42 for the dates. So the minimum is, the least amount is through wheat and barley. And if Allah has bestowed you and blessed you with more, and brothers and sisters, I always say this so often, that alhamdulillah, with what Allah has favored us with, our 2.5% is sometimes much more than the 100% of so many people across the globe. So if Allah has bestowed you and favored you with financial ease and comfort, then give more than the amount of barley. Give equal to the amount of dates, which is $40, or raisins or things like that, which is $42 per person, per household, which is known as Sadaqatul Fitr, Zakatul Fitr, or Fitrana. These are all three same names which the money is supposed to be given before the day of Eid itself. May Allah give us tawfiq and ability, inshallah. You can definitely drive through. We also have the links as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to practice whatever good has been said. Keep me and the entire ummah in your dua, for indeed it is the time that we should all keep one another in your dua. We will see you tonight at 9 p.m. inshallah for our nightly reflections. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.